It smells like...
Shit. I'm sorry. I shouldn't talk like that.
That was a swear. I missed my mom and dad.
I bet, Clem.
How far is Savannah?
Pretty far.
Oh, okay.
I love you, baby.
Hey, get up.
I'm itchy.
Well, you slept in a barn, little lady. Lucky you don't have spiders in your hair. But I bet your daddy scared them all away, huh?
I'm not her dad. Name's Lee.
I'm Kenny.
Dad, we're in the middle of a fence. There's a tractor and everything.
We better get going, or we won't hear the end of it. That's my boy, Ken Jr. We call him Duck, though.
Doc?
Yeah, nothing bothers him. Like water off a duck's back, you know?
That's a valuable trait lately.
No kidding. But frankly, I think it's because he's dumb as a bag of hammers.
Dad!
But he makes up for it with enthusiasm. The word is you were on your way to Macon.
My family's from there.
Well, Macon's on the way, and personally, I'd appreciate the company of a guy who can knock a couple of heads together if he has to.
I'll see what the girl would like.
Ah, gotta consult the missus. I understand. Honey, Duck, this is Lee. And, what's the girl's name?
Clementine.
Clementine.
That is a very pretty name.
Thanks.
Well, we should get to work. We've all seen what those things can do out there, so the faster we get this fence up, the better.
I want to build a fence.
Yeah? Well, I need a good foreman. You can sit on the tractor and yell at me whenever I take a water break.
On the tractor? Cool!
Duck and I will hop to it.
I can keep an eye on your little girl here on the porch. We can visit.
It's not the most reliable pickup in the world, but it gets the job done.
Hey there, Kenny. Need any help?
No, I think I got it. Do you need any help?
What do you mean?
Well, I mean in taking care of that little girl. You know what you're doing? You got kids of your own?
Nah, no kids.
Would have liked one then.
You know. How's your son doing?
Good, I think. Kachi's got a sister up in Memphis. We were coming back from visiting her. We were in a gas station and some guy grabbed my boy. I thought he was kidnapping him. I was on the fucker in about 2 seconds and... Christ. Just lucky I was there. We saw a lot of bodies before we stumbled upon Herschel's, but... We're a tough family, Lee. Ain't nothing gonna faze us.
So what's your family's plan?
Get back on down to Lauderdale and let this mess get sorted out. Government will start handing out shots and the National Guard will do its thing. On the odd chance things got too bad, we could hop on my boat, I guess.
You've got a boat?
I'm a commercial fisherman, catching mackerel, dolphin, whatever's biting and paying. Kachi wouldn't be wild about it, but the boat's not that bad.
See you. Hey there, girls. You two actually look relaxed.
I think we're doing just fine. Clementine was just telling me about first grade.
Oh, how's that?
It's easy.
Well, yeah. So, you're good?
Anyway, it's almost like we didn't see people eating each other for the past 3 days. It's peaceful here, no?
How did you handle getting through the city?
Kenny just drove. We passed so many people that needed help, and we just passed people over some.
It's okay. It's fine. You don't have to say anymore.
I want to go home tomorrow, but even then I can't take away the things Doc went through. Don't you want to go back to the moment before you knew about all of this?
Anybody in their right mind would. Families and barbecues and beers with good friends.
All of those things.
Those are the things we live for, right? With those gone, what's the point? So, what do you do when corpses aren't walking around?
I'm a veterinarian back in Fort Lauderdale, like Herschel here, except more with dogs and cats and not horses. What is it that you do, Lee?
I used to teach up at the University of Georgia.
We need to hope that we can go back to our jobs soon, Lee. Back to normal. It can't stay like this.
No, I used to. I was let go a little while back.
That's too bad. Well, I hear people always clamor back to college after a big disaster. People don't want to die ignorant, I guess.
Back in a bit.
Okay, Lee.
You having a nice time with Katya Clementine?
Yeah.
Do you have to go to the bathroom or anything like that?
Lee, the young woman can take care of herself.
Yeah, okay. Seems like those two are getting along. Do you, think this thing will keep them out?
Not yet. I'm planning on coming back through on a fortification pass, if you will. We'll lock this place up good.
Sean's still working on that fence.
You know how to drive it?
Sure don't. I can give you a hell of a critique of the U.S. Farm Bill, though.
I'm good.
How you doing, Duck?
Good! I'm gonna drive the tractor. I'm the foreman. Lift with your back, Sean.
Hey, Lee.
Need a hand?
That'd be great. If you could cut those two-bys to length, that'd sure speed things up. My dad doesn't know how bad it is.
No, he doesn't.
I saw a guy in Atlanta kill a kid. A boy. Just shot him right in the face.
Was the boy one of the walkers?
I don't even know. He was either attacking the guy or asking for help. He didn't even hesitate. He just turned, put the barrel of the gun right between the kid's eyes, and pulled the trigger. You don't see things like that. It's not like in the movies.
They don't fall like you think.
Did you have to do it?
Do what?
Kill. Have you had to off one yet?
I bashed a poor girl's brains in.
Whoa. I couldn't do that. I'm just glad we're getting this fence built. Dad just wants to keep the family safe and thinks inviting people in is a bigger threat than whatever's out there. How about yours? How's your family?
My brother and parents are in Macon, I hope.
Oh man, I hope so too. Maybe it's not too bad there. That's probably all I need cut for now. Thanks.
And Sean, thanks again for the ride.
No problem, Lee. Couldn't leave you behind. Anyway, when you see my dad around, he might want some help in the barn.